Jacob, bearer of the promise. Almost 4,000 years ago, a man named Abraham heard the call of God and left his home in Haran to come to the land of Canaan. And now his son, Isaac, was married to a young woman of Haran named Rebekah. And Abraham was happy. For Rebekah was the granddaughter of Nahor, Abraham's brother, and a worshiper of the one true God. A woman who would help fulfill the promise that someday all the nations of the earth would be blessed through the descendant of Abraham. The years passed, and God blessed Isaac and Rebekah with twin boys. The firstborn was named Esau because his skin was hairy. The second was called Jacob. And Rebekah often thought of something God had said to her before their birth. The older one will serve the younger. Although the boys were twins, they grew up very different in character. Esau became an expert hunter, a man who roamed the hills and forests, while Jacob was a thoughtful and hard-working man who took care of his father's herds and flocks and loved the quiet of his tent. One day, Esau came home tired and hungry and smelled the food Jacob was preparing for himself.
Let me have some of that right away, Jacob. I'm about to die of hunger.
I will, if you will sell me your rights as the oldest son.
As the firstborn son, Esau was to become the head of the family after Isaac's death and also the ancestor of the Messiah. But he answered thoughtlessly.
What good is my birthright to me?
Wait. First, you must swear to me that you'll do it. Swear.
As the Lord lives, I swear it. You shall have all my rights as firstborn.
In this way, Jacob gained the rights of his older brother. And he was glad, because he saw that all the promises which God had made to Abraham would now belong to him and to his own family. As Isaac grew older, his eyesight became so poor that he could not see. Fearing that he might not live much longer, he decided the time had come to give his firstborn son the blessing which would place Esau at the head of the family.
Esau, my son.
Yes, father.
I am old. I do not know when I'm going to die. Now then, my son, go take your quiver and your bow. And hunt some game for me. Then prepare a delicious meal just as I like it. And bring it to me to eat. And then I will bless you.
Yes, Father.
When Rebekah heard this, her heart rebelled at the thought of the blessing going to Esau. Had not God said, "The older one shall serve the younger"? Prompted by her love for Jacob, Rebekah decided to act quickly to make sure that the blessing of the firstborn would not go to Esau, but to Jacob.
I just heard your father tell your brother Esau, "Get me game and prepare me some food. Then I will bless you. Now, Jacob, do what I tell you. Go quickly to the flock and bring me two young goats, and I will prepare the food for your father just as he likes it. And you must bring it to your father to eat and have him bless you before he dies."
Jacob had openly obtained the rights of the firstborn from Esau. But should he deceive his father in order to get his blessing? In his heart, Jacob was troubled. But he expressed only one fear.
Mother, you know that Esau is a hairy man while I am smooth. Suppose my father touches me, then I'll bring a curse on myself instead of a blessing.
Let any curse that can fall on you be on me. Just do as I say and go. Get the goats for me.
Rebekah had planned well. She put Esau's best clothes on Jacob and fastened pieces of goatskin on his hands and neck so that they were no longer smooth. And Rebekah gave him the food which she herself had prepared. At first, Isaac had some doubts as to who was in the room. The voice was like Jacob's, but when Isaac felt the hairy hands and noticed the smell of the fields on his garments, then he believed that this was really Esau, his oldest son, and he gave Jacob his blessing.
May God give you the dew of heaven and the fertile places of the earth, with plenty of grain and wine. Let people serve you, and nations bow down before you. Be the rule over your brothers, and may your mother's sons bow down before you. Cursed be those who curse you, and blessed be everyone who blesses you.
Jacob now had the blessing of his father, and worried over what he had done, he hurried away. And not a moment too soon, for he scarcely had disappeared when...
My father, here is the game I prepared for you, that you may bless me.
Who are you?
I'm your firstborn son, Esau.
Who was it then that hunted game and brought it to me? And I have blessed him. Yes, and he shall stay blessed.
Bless me too, O my father.
Then his father answered, saying, you will live away from the fertile places of the earth and away from the dew that falls from heaven. And full of hate for his brother, Esau said to himself, my father will die soon, and then I'll kill Jacob. Rebekah was certain that unless the brothers were separated at once, there would be bloodshed and grief. So she told Isaac that the time had come for Jacob to find a wife, and that he must not marry someone outside of his own people as Esau had done.
Do not marry any of the women of Canaan, but go to the plain of Syria and marry a daughter of Laban, your mother's brother.
Yes, father.
Then Isaac blessed Jacob and sent him on his journey. Now Jacob would be safe from Esau's anger, but his leaving meant that Rebekah might never see her beloved son again. So Jacob left the only home he had ever known. That night as he slept, Jacob had a strange and wonderful dream. He saw a ladder standing on the earth and the top of it reaching up to heaven. And the angels of God were going up and down on it. And the Lord spoke to Jacob in his dream, saying,
I am the Lord, the God of your grandfather Abraham. The land on which you are lying I will give to you and to your descendants. And by your descendants, all the people in the world will be blessed. And now I shall be with you and will protect you wherever you go. And I will bring you back to this land.
Surely the Lord is in this place. And I didn't know it. It's nothing less than the house of God. And here is the gate of heaven.
In the morning, Jacob rose early and took the stone on which he had rested his head and set it up as a pillar and poured oil on it. And Jacob made a solemn vow to the Lord.
If you will be with me and will give me food to eat and clothing to wear so that I come back safely to my father's house, then you will be my God, and I will give you a tenth of everything you give me.
Then, assured of God's favor and strengthened by his promises, Jacob continued his journey to Haran, toward the home of Laban, his mother's brother. And when Jacob at last arrived in Haran, he saw some shepherds resting by a well, and he asked them about his uncle.
Laban, the grandson of Nahor? Yes, we know him.
Is he well?
Yes, he is well.
See, here comes his daughter Rachel now to water his sheep.
Rachel, the younger daughter of Laban, was beautiful. And when Jacob saw her, he rolled the stone from the opening of the well and helped water the flock. Then Jacob told Rachel, "I'm Rebekah's son." And she hurried to tell her father so that he would come out to welcome Jacob. Jacob stayed at his uncle's place, and although Laban had an older daughter, Leah, Jacob fell in love with Rachel, and he agreed to serve his uncle 7 years if he could marry Rachel. But because Laban wanted to have his older daughter married first, he tricked Jacob. And at the end of the 7 years...
What did you do to me? I worked for you for 7 years in order to have Rachel as my wife. Why? Why then did you cheat me?
In our country, we do not give a younger daughter in marriage before the oldest one. But you may have Rachel too if you'll agree to work for me another 7 years.
So Jacob, who had deceived his father, was now learning how painful it is to be deceived. But because of his deep love for Rachel, he agreed to his uncle's terms. As the years passed, Jacob prospered greatly. The Lord gave him a large family and many flocks and herds. But still his heart was not at rest. He longed to see his homeland again, to make peace with his brother Esau. So with his family and his servants and all his flocks, Jacob journeyed from Haran and crossed the Jabbok River, where they camped for the night. 20 years had passed since Esau had threatened to kill Jacob. What if Esau had not forgiven him for taking his blessing? The night before he met his brother, Jacob turned to the Lord in prayer and wrestled with him until daybreak. Because Jacob firmly clung to God in faith, God told him, "Your name will be Israel, for you have fought with God and have won." But in the struggle, Jacob's hip was injured. And from that time on, he walked with a limp. In the morning, Jacob hurried ahead to meet his brother, to whom he had already sent gifts with which to win his favor. And when Jacob saw Esau approaching, he bowed low 7 times to show his desire for his brother's love and friendship. So the years of bitterness were over, and the two brothers were again at peace. But one more reunion awaited Jacob, the reunion with his father Isaac, who was still living. Many long years had passed since that day when Isaac, believing that he was about to die, had given his blessing to Jacob. But now, with Jacob before him, safe at home again, with a family and great possessions, Isaac felt certain that God's will had been done, and that his son Jacob was indeed the rightful bearer of God's promise.